telling me we're hitting them all with the whole team. Nah, nigga, can't let the call cause I'm balling. I was waking up getting racks in the morning. I was broke, now I'm rich, these niggas salty. All this designer on my body got me drip drip. Straight up out the objects, I'm a big crew. If I got up on a lean, I'm a sip sip. I run a wrestle with my queen, like London and Nip. But I got rich on all these niggas, I did it for get back.
What's up, K's family? Back with another banger video. Great news I seen on NMDTV. He posted up on the West Car. I lost vision. Photo, you know, whatever. We keep it real. Keep it 1,000. That's the morning. Wake up, slide. I got a little cold in my eye. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But you know, songs speak a million words. Real Kane stuff every morning, every evening, every night. So my boy Perry is about to be balling. That's why I play that song, Balling. My DJ Mustard, Future Rashad. My boy finna be balling because he will be starting this Friday. I hate that I ain't going to be able to watch the game because I will be at my homeboy's. I'm trying to get this thing on my fucking eye, bro. Got some chicken. Pickle in the shit. Really got to excuse the eye thing. Just call it an eyeball. But anyway. So, my boy Perry going to be balling. I see Manny really had no choice. I mean, after a game like that, 400 yard passing game, you got no choice but to play the baller. He been a baller. And now, it's time for him to shine. Do y'all understand the magnitude of what this brings? All Perry has to do is win this game, and he will never be questioned about that starter position again. Ever again. That's all he got to do is win. Oh, that's my eye. I thought it was an eye booger. This is my eye. But anyway, so yeah, they claim that Jaren Williams has a messed up shoulder. What I heard, it was a non-thrown shoulder injury, no thrown arm shoulder injury, which is kind of BS. They just had to make an excuse because the guys played so bad, to be honest. That's what it really was. I know Manny don't like it, but Eno's loving it right now. So, me personally, word for Jerry, just keep doing your thing. You been a baller. You pull out the W's, just go ahead and do what you do, guy. You know what to do. Win this game. You already know how to win. Go ahead. I really ain't got nothing to say other than sure. They knew what it was. They knew what time it was. They knew Jerry wasn't ready. You had all the adversity the first game. You couldn't handle it. Second game, couldn't handle it. Third game, you won against Bethune-Cookman. Yeah, we could have put Jimmy Murphy back there and fucking blew FAMU Bethune, whatever what it was. We played that third game. Jimmy Murphy could have went out there and quarterback that shit. Yeah, we could have had Proctor back there throwing that thing. Hell, shit. Yeah, Bo Bax could have threw it. Against that team, hate to say it like that. No disrespect to the HBCU, but just being honest. And then Central Michigan, that was damn sure adversity because they had 17-12. That's not a good look. But say Jerry Williams, your time is up, buddy. Your time is up. It's Perry time. It should have been Perry time since last season, and I've been saying that. Now y'all get to see a team that's young but talented, and they get to show it. And there's no more excuses now. Cause Perry gonna win the game. Then what you gonna say? We still got a young team. And this, that, and third. Man, all you gotta do is take over the defense from Baker and get them boys right. And then after that, they just needed to know that the offense was going to score. And they would have turned up, just like they did when Perry came in. Players know if stuff won't work, so they won't play for you. If they know that you're going to sit there and sabotage a team by putting in people that don't fit the scheme or don't fit what they're trying to do, which is win, then so they ain't going to give you what's the point of going out there and knowing that they're going to be a three and out every fucking down, they're going to be on the field all the fucking time. How they going to give you a day off? Answer that question. They know they're going to be tired trying to bust their ass to get you the ball back just to what? Get back out there and get your ball back again. Now it's Paris time Friday. Y'all watch this baller. Just watch him. I do want to see what Junior Big Dog got to say about this. I think they do it go live. I know they go live. Normally they go live Thursday, but I think they're supposed to go live today or tomorrow. I don't know. But I want to hear what Junior Big Dog has to say about Jerry. And they have to say about Perry. Because it's going to be interesting. Because Jerry was their guy. And I knew Jerry would fit. Jerry would fit Eno's scheme if he was really accurate like Manny Diaz claimed that he was. But now looking at it, hopefully the Junior Big Dog see that Perry could have fit the scheme for the offensive line that we have now and for the wide receivers that we have now. And we gotta understand that, you know what I'm saying, Perry been that guy to make plays. He was always the one to take risks. And don't get me wrong now. I think Tate would have did a better job right about now with the offensive line that we got compared to Jerry. Be honest. Cause he's quicker than Jerry. And he liked to run, so. Jerry just gotta go to an SEC team. That's the only way Jerry gonna succeed as a quarterback is if he has a great offensive line. Cause he needs that time in that pocket. This ain't that type of team, this ain't that type of conference where you got time to sit your ass back in the goddamn shotgun, off of the eye form play action where you can sit all day. This is the fact, if you think about it, ACC is the speed conference. ACC is the power conference. Okay, what I mean by that is that ACC has the offensive linemen that can block for days. You understand what I'm saying? Because they got them real big boys. Okay, ACC got them boys that's kind of stocky, but it's speed. They only got a certain amount of time to hold for you. You can see that with every team in the ACC. Even Clemson. Clemson don't have no big boys. They have big boys, but don't have no big boys like the SEC do. They have big boys to hold long enough to get the run or the pass out. We saw that with Trevor Lawrence when he struggled against North Carolina. So, Jared, you more likely going to have to transfer and go to the SEC team. That's the only way you're going to succeed. And then that even shows even more. That shows even more that you're going to have to basically step your technique up in your craft when it comes to if you think about going to NFL. Because you ain't going to always have a good offensive line. No quarterback ever really does in NFL. I mean, it rarely happens. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, but, you know, he'll get his opportunity either with us later or never. Or with another team. But it's not going to happen this season. But I just wanted to go ahead and drop this video for y'all, man, this morning because I saw what I saw. I'm excited. Hopefully he continues to be the quarterback the rest of the season. And the seasons from here on until Van Dyke get here. When Van Dyke get here, we'll have a better offensive line for him. Because that's how I see it. I think Perry should start until he graduates, to be honest with you. That's just my thing. But anyway, man. I might be dropping another video if I find anything else later on today. So, you know what I'm saying? And we out, man. Dude, ball like a hot boy. Water. All right, Hurricane. See y'all later, baby. See ya, Hurricane family.